Okay. I'm working on this jeans quilt, putting the rows together, and I thought I would show the process. When you're working with what you have instead of what you would like to have, various concessions have to be made. So, for instance, if you have any difference, you always take it up just simply with pins. And I don't mind pinning. If you take the time to pin, then generally the time to unsew is reduced or eliminated. So you pin one side. And yes, I always put two, because you're sewing on two ankles. And then that's pretty even fitting in there. If there were any ripples where one was wrinkled more, if you pull and gently stretch, and then go midway and put a pin. And every time that you have you're making a seam, and the pieces aren't, that's acceptable there. If it was any more than that, then you would pull that and pin up there. So here we go. That looks fairly decent. And it's just positioning for your initial stabbing of the fabric and get that positioned where you want it. Come on. And go up a couple and go back a couple. Then that pin can come out. And then you always make sure that your raw edges are parallel. Check the raw edges that they're parallel. So, hold the pin. So when you take that one out, this one will still hold them together.
Do we run out of bobbin or something? What the devil is that?
Okay, something's going on.
What the devil?
It's jolly fun. Okay. Nothing like having things get messed up. Okay, I don't know where that other piece of thread got in there. What I'm gonna do, this is fine here. I'm gonna go back to here and just over sew it. Just to make sure the seam doesn't open up. All right, gang. The thread came out. Try this again. There. That's better. Okay. Now, if I can readjust, ow, this thing. There's that rope. And all these seams are going to bloom. It's smaller. After the rows are sewn together, and then it's put together this way, 2, 2, 2, then 2, 2, then it goes in the washer, and all of the, this is what I meant, when you get to something where you have no control over how much fabric you have, if you pull a bit, you can even out so that everything comes out square. When you're doing the border top and bottom, you measure 3 points and you take the average, and that's what you cut both and you make them fit. And then to do the side borders, you do the same thing. You measure the 3 positions, take an average, cut 2 pieces of fabric that size, and you make everything fit, and then it comes out square. It takes a little time, but it's foolproof. So, and here's another one, and this. So these 2 blocks, See, there's a difference here, about 3/8 of an inch. So the way that is remedied is to get that corner together. Then top and side. And then pin this corner together. And you see the difference that's here? That's not fitting. And all you do is snug keep the edges together. Snug that until it's flat. Put a pin. And I always come and see this right in here, that gap. You do the same thing. You just snug between those pins. And I come up from the bottom. And that way there's less chance of distortion. So this one also. Then we can sew that one together. And back stitch to lock it in place. Remove the first pin. Sure that always keep the raw edges in line. That's what's of most importance. And again, the one on the side keeps this even. There, that's how you fit a smaller piece of fabric to a larger piece of fabric and get it to fit. See? And the same thing would be done here and here and here, wherever that adjustment is required. That's how simple it is, and it works. So I'm going to go ahead and sew up a few more of these rows, and then I'll make another one of these low-budget videos. Thanks for watching.